Hi, this is Sarah Marks, one of the librarians here at UMass Lowell. I'm doing a video today to show you PubMed Central. And the way to get to this, Google PubMed Central. You don't want general PubMed, you want PubMed Central. The reason is this is the free full text archive for medical research, and it's from the National Institute of Health and the National Library of Medicine. So you're getting peer review and review articles and systematic reviews and all sorts of amazing articles for free. And that's always a good thing. So here we are at the PMC webpage. Now there are multiple PubMed collections, and you can see here there's a drop-down menu, and there's going to be a ton of options, including something that says PubMed. Now the difference is this one has the free content, and that's what you want. You want the free content. You are able to search with mesh headings. If you go into the advanced search, you'll be able to limit yourself to mesh terms if you know them already. So you can use our Medline collection to find out those mesh terms and then bring them here and do your search with them. So I am going to do all fields diabetes, and you can see it starts creating the search for me up here as well as down here. So I can add things in like if I know the specific journal, I can add that in. But I'm just going to do diabetes so you can see how this works. And so I have 400,000 hits. It is showing me the NIH grants research articles. So when NIH grants you something, the typical process is that once you've written your article, you make it freely available to the public, and that is through here. So we have, here's our first one, diabetes insipidus, the other diabetes. And you can see it says article, pub reader, citation. These are three different levels. Article, click on that, and it shows you the article in its entirety. Yes. And it periodically gives you related articles on the right. Yes. And it shows you the figures. It's lovely. Back, pub reader. This is even better because this is an e-reader version of it, and you can print from here, but you can save it to your NCIB. So here is your PubReader feedback and control area. So you can make the font bigger, smaller, do it two column, one column. You can give them feedback. You can save it. You can see the organization. So if you really just need to see their review methods, because this is a review article specifically, you can go to the section that is review methods. So you have the ability to also search for words, like let's make sure we see the word diabetes and where it comes back. So if you're looking for specific words to come up, you're looking at a specific section, you need to see what kind of review methods you might use for review articles. This is a great way to find them. And then citation gives you the basic citations. Now, if you need this to go into EndNote, please use the RIS format and then go through the EndNote process. But you can get these articles into your EndNote collections with links back to PubMed Central. And when you are on the article version, you can get a printer-friendly version, and this is a way for you to attach it to an EndNote citation if you're using EndNote, or to save a version of this article if you prefer to print it. So you have these free options through PubMed Central. There is no paying for these. These are already paid for. This is freely available research, and it has a lot of overlap with our Medline PubMed subscription. So you want to make sure you get both just to get any outliers on either side. But this one you know you can count on for free. So if you're in a crunch and you need some research and you need it now and you need it free, come to PubMed Central. This is where medical research is. It doesn't have all those amazing limits as Medline, but it has a lot more free stuff. And sometimes that's all you really need, isn't it?